and working with them. He realized he had a great, exceptional dog in
Rin-Tin-Tin.
And he wanted to learn everything he could about the German Shepherd dog breed. He joined the German Shepherd Dog Club of America and started bringing him to shows and everything. How he got into the movies was really a twist of fate. He was coming across a movie, because he did live in California, and they were trying to film where a wolf was supposed to do a certain scene, and the wolf was not cooperating, and Lee Duncan told the director that his dog could do it in one take. After finally pestering him and they finally let him do it, the dog did it in one take, and thus began the movie career of Rin-Tin-Tin. He was the first to receive Best Male Actor when the Oscars were first started.
However,
they felt giving it to a dog wouldn't be as the prestige that they wanted the Oscars to be, so they gave it to a German actor instead. Rin-Tin-Tin and Annette had a litter of puppies, and Lee Duncan kept one of the puppies and named him Junior. Now, Junior was not the stature of his father. The original Rin-Tin-Tin weighed about 85 pounds. Junior topped the scale at over 110 pounds. He also didn't have this personality or the drive as the original Rin-Tin-Tin, his father. Lee Duncan then bred Junior to a female, and he got an exceptional puppy, and he named him Rin-Tin-Tin 3. Now back then, AKC didn't have the numbers, so they're not listed as Rin-Tin-Tin number 3. So I'm kind of just giving the chronology of that. Rin-Tin-Tin 3 was an exceptional puppy. At the age of 2 months, he passed his training in puppyhood. You smell that? Good boy. Good job. That was from yesterday. Rin-Tin-Tin number 3 passed his puppy training at the age of 2 months and was awarded the official mascot for the Boy Scouts of America, which was kind of cool. By then it was 1941, and we all know what happened in 1941, Pearl Harbor happened. Lee Duncan wanted to join the war effort again, but he couldn't as a soldier, so they asked him to be in the Army and enlisted both him and Rin-Tin-Tin to train all the dogs that went into the military. They trained over 5,000 dogs at Camp Han and served their country for 4 years. Upon the end of the war, they began the process of discharging, as well as the men that were enlisted, all the dogs. And all the dogs that came back were placed in specific areas of service work. Unfortunately, during the war, Junior had passed away from pneumonia, and Rin-Tin-Tin 3's mother was lost in the war effort. That brings us kind of up to Rin-Tin-Tin number 4. How many remember The Adventures of Rin-Tin-Tin? Series ran from 1954 to 1959. It was 164 episodes shot. That was a series with Rin-Tin-Tin 4 and his pal Rusty. Lee Duncan was always there on set with the dogs. They were very well taken care of. And I say dogs plural because there was another one that was there that did some of the swimming scenes and stuff. When the series ended in 1959, it was due to the ailing health of Lee Duncan. He did pass away in 1960. Little did everybody know that a young lady down in Texas was very interested in the Rin-Tin-Tin line, so she bought a couple puppies from Lee Duncan and thus started breeding Rin-Tin-Tin dogs. So what happened after the series ended, and we have from then till now? Well, Janetta Frost got her first Rin-Tin-Tin puppies from Lee Duncan, started breeding her dogs, and along with her daughter's granddaughter, Daphne Herford, they started doing the show scene with the dogs and took a lot of dogs to the Houston Police Department. There was also a Rin-Tin-Tin dog that worked in the Pentagon after 9/11 hit. So these dogs have always been active in service work. They also started a foundation called ARF Kids, and that provides service dogs with children.
You want to wear this?
This guy right here, he is a service dog. He has received a certification in CGC, and he has a certification for therapy dog. He volunteers at Anoka County Correctional Facility in Lionel Lakes, and he works with juvenile offenders. So the Rin-Tin-Tin dogs are very active. There is another litter that just arrived on Sunday from Rin-Tin-Tin Denali and Rin-Tin-Tin Lady Rachel. They had 4 puppies. So this is a living legacy. It's the longest living line of dogs in AKC history.
Woo!
Lee Duncan's dream, there will always be a Rin-Tin-Tin dog. Rin-Tin-Tin dogs are known for their temperament, their desire to work, their desire to please. They're very honest. They have honor. They have love. They have loyalty. They have principle.
I want one.
Paul could learn a little.
They also love people. Like I said, I invite all of you up after I'm done. Everyone's more than welcome to come in the ring, have pictures taken with him, pet him. He's very social. He does some tricks, like 26 of them. He remembers them more than I do. So how are we doing on time, Janice? Good? We're good. All right, so we're going to do a couple tricks. Wave to your people.
Hi.
I trained him with positive reinforcement training. Wave to your people. Your people are right there. Can you wave? Thank you. <laughs> I think he wants Cheerios. He loves Cheerios. Wave to your people. Wave to your people. Woo! Yes, good. Well, you got people back here. Look at these people back here. You've never been back here. Wow. Hey, sweetie. Hi. Wave to the people. Yes.
Good boy.
People have been fascinated with the Rin-Tin-Tin dogs forever. A lot of people remember Lassie as well, and they think that Rin-Tin-Tin and Lassie had a rivalry. There's stuff written by that. They do not have rivalries.
No.
Their owners actually got along very well. So that is one of the little fictions that we like to get back out there that is not a fact. It was the media that created that rivalry. There was no rivalry between the dogs. Or it was the producers that wanted everybody to have their ratings and have their shows be on top. So I'm going to do... Oh, let's go over here on your table. Let's go over here.
Oh, cute. Look at that.
So we're going to count. I'm sorry if my back is turned to you. Let's count. Ready? Ready?
Good boy. Good boy.
He gets paid. He likes to work, but he also gets paid. How many of you work for free? I do, but he doesn't. So he can go forward. Oh, it's kind of big. Beep, 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 beep. Oh, you want to go that way? Beep, 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 beep. Ready? Beep, 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 beep. Good boy. Good job. Dogs are left paw, right paw. So I taught him that he needs to go right to silly. You're silly, yes, I know. You're super silly. Oh my gosh, you're dizzy. Good job. Good boy. Ladies, we all know what our core is, correct?
Yeah.
So, Zip, he's got to work on his core. He's got to keep his fitness and his physique. So that's his core. Hold it. Good job. Now we're going to sit and go all the way up. Yes.
Good boy.
That's working on your core. We'll come over here and do it. Core is huge when you have a performance dog, which he is. Performance, I mean, he's an athlete. Oh, you're going to just scared you so you know? Do you know? Okay. Now good. Yes.
Wow.
German Shepherds are extremely intelligent, so they'll give you the trick before you even ask them, because that's how smart they are. So that just brings us over to our little old jump here. Let's go. Yes. Go. That's only 24 inches. I know he could probably jump 36. But he does compete in agility, so I want to keep his physique going. I'm going to go one more time.
Good boy.
Yes, when I walk away. Oh, I dropped the bar. Good job. When he's around little children, we have a cue word. Ready? Baby. Stay. He will lay down at the word of baby. Baby's his cue word. He needs to lay down. If there's a little toddler, I don't want his face right in that little toddler's, you know, right there. So he lays down. He's a gentleman. And he will stay there.
Good
job. Yay. Good boy. So he will do this. Ready? Baby.
Aww.
Oh, now you're going to roll over.
Oh, cute.
Nine-nine. Okay. Now, he can, like, play dead, but we kind of don't do that at the fair. Now, you girls, when you're in school and you're on fire, what do they teach you?
Drop.
Stop.
Drop and roll.
Roll. Good job.
Yay.
He's ever on fire. Good boy. You know, because he's a pretty hot dog. Ready? Stop. Drop. Roll. Good boy. Now, baby. Oh, now you're dead again? Okay. You're such an overachiever. You are. Good job. Dogs can have over a 500-word vocabulary.
Great.
I'm not sure how many he has. I just know I train him because he has all these toys. The biggest trick is if he put his toys away, it would be great. This dog is Gator. This is Ursula, his octopus. This is Bob, his shark. No, we're not playing with the bee again. This is Kermit. Hey, here's Kermit. And even though he's a boy, he's got to have a flower. Excuse me.